the thing that I suppose surprised me most is I thought this would be quite a niche show. You know, I thought some people would like it, but I think this the sort of the audience figures we caught and stuff were just sort mind-blowing for all of us. We really weren't expecting that. I love being able to show a side of Northern Ireland that hasn't been seen before. I love telling female-centred stories. So that, for me, is the big thing about being able to do more of this. And I'm really excited to continue their stories.
I think obviously for season three, we're talking about a very transformative point in the history for Ireland. I'm curious if that's going to be matched by a transformation in the characters, or if they're going to be the same lovely bag of dicks we've always come to know and love.
I think when you have a backdrop like Northern Ireland in the 90s, there was nothing secure about it. It was always changing, even with the beginnings of the peace process, you know. We didn't know it was going to work. There was a lot of nervousness surrounding it, and it seemed to fall down a lot. So I think one thing I want to do is keep the gang, the sort of steady heart of the show that people can rely on. And so essentially, they'll go off on their various journeys, but they'll come back together, and they'll be the same, you know, because I think audiences take great comfort in that as well, you know.
Do you have a message to fans of the series who've loved and supported it and can't wait for hopefully many more series to come?
Just thank you for watching and for sticking with us. And yeah, we're incredibly grateful. Thanks.